Arena. For tonight's game between the Mount St. Mary's University Mountaineers and your Coppin State University Eagles. The NCAA Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, Coppin State University and Mount St. Mary's University encourage and promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, ethnic, or sexual comments or other intimidating actions will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the PEC arena. Ladies and gentlemen, prior to tonight's game, Coppin State would like to recognize one of its men's basketball players for their historic performance last season. During the 2021-22 season, Nenda Tark led the nation with an impressive 2.94 steals per game while setting a school record 94 steals in 32 games. Please welcome to the floor, from a sophomore from Gaithersburg, Maryland, this is number 4, Nenda Tark. Congratulations, Nenda Tark. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to all please rise and honor America, especially on this Veterans Day. We honor the servicemen and women across the country. We ask you please rise for the singing of our national anthem. Here to sing our national anthem, members of the Voices of CSU, Kathy Martin, Andrea Brown, and Daniel Parrish, along with their advisor, Kevin Carr.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose bright stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, was so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bumper.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Voices of CSU. And if you'd like to become a member of the Voices of CSU, please give a call at 410-951-3090. That's 410-951-3090. Or email kcarr@coppin.edu. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are your starting lineup for tonight's game. First, for the visiting Mountaineers of Mount St. Mary's University. At forward, 6'6", and a senior from Clark Summit, Pennsylvania, number 11, George Tinsley. At forward, 6'7", and a junior from Brno, Czech Republic, number 24, Fratichek Bartone. At forward, 6'9", and a graduate student from Hopewell, Virginia, number 42, Malik Jefferson. At guard, 6'5", and a junior from Hampton, Georgia, number 1, Dakota LaFue. And at guard, 5'10 and a senior from Raleigh, North Carolina, number 5, Jalen Benjamin. Mount St. Mary's assistant coaches are Matt Miller and Justin Burrell. The associate head coach is Will Holland. And the head coach of the Mount St. Mary's University Mountaineers is Dan Engelstad. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the starting lineup for your Coppin State University Eagles. At forward, 6'8" and a junior from Sydney, Australia, number 24, Daniel Titus. At forward, 6'8" and a senior from West Orange, New Jersey, number 35, Justin Winston. At guard, 6'7" and senior from Greenville, South Carolina, number 10, Cameron Blue. At guard, 6 feet and a senior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 3, Sam Sessom. And at guard, 6'4" and a sophomore from Gaithersburg, Maryland, number 4, Nenda Tark. Eagle assistant coaches are Eric Skeeters, Kent Auslander, Jermaine Dixon, and Marvin Bragg. Director of Basketball Operations, Brianna Gross. The associate head coach is John Auslander. And the head coach of your Eagles is Juan Dixon.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome inside the PEC Arena for tonight's non-conference battle between the visiting Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers and your Coppin State University Eagles. I'm Kyle Borg, and I will have all the play-by-play for you here this evening on the radio and on the live stream. Coppin State comes in at 0-2 on the season. Mount St. Mary's comes in at 0-1 on the year. They play in the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference. It is their first year after leaving the NEC for the MAAC this year. Mount St. Mary's will be in the road blues with the gold trim, the word "the Mount" written across the chest, gold letters front and back. They will start Dakota LeFou, Jalen Benjamin, George Tinsley, František Bartone, and Malik Jefferson. Coppin in the white with the blue numbers front and back. Winston will tip. It is Winston, blue, Titus, who in Coppin wins the tip to Titus. Sessoms and Tark round out the Coppin State Eagles lineup. And we have a quick stoppage in play as we got to get the shot clock on track with the game clock. We'll wait for the officials to be happy. Our three-man of tonight, our crew chief is Jose Carrion, Howard Davis, and Larry Johnson Jr. are your three officials here this evening for your contest. Coppin again in the white with the blue numbers front and back, and Sessoms will start the offense. The Penn State transfer for Coppin State, first possession of the game, and once again a stoppage as the shot clock still not rolling when the clock does. Having some issues over there at the scores table as we start this one off. 12 seconds has come off the clock officially, and now the clock continues to run momentarily. They got to make sure that everybody's good over at the table. Once again, your starters for both sides. For the visiting Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers, led by fifth-year head coach Dan Engelstad, is number 1, Dakota LeFou, number 5, Jalen Benjamin, number 11, George Tinsley, number 24, František Bartone, and the graduate student is number 42, Malik Jefferson. Coppin State starters, the redshirt senior number 3, Sam Sessoms. The redshirt sophomore number 4, Nenda Tark, in a preseason first-team All-MEAC selection. The redshirt senior and the transfer from Fordham and Mississippi Valley State number 10, Cameron Blue. The redshirt junior number 24, Daniel Titus. And the senior transfer from Robert Morris number 35, Justin Winston. Your five starters for the Eagles. These five have started the first two games for Coppin State, who lost to Charlotte to open the year on Monday, then returned back to the area to travel to Georgetown down at Capital One Arena and lost that one by 10 in overtime, 99-89, after Mike Hood hit his only shot from the floor for the game at the buzzer It was a rebound three-point try off the Nenda Tark miss that hit the front of the rim, bounced right to the left wing, where Mike Hood picked it up and got the three-point try to fall to force overtime, but it was not enough for Coppin State to come away victorious. They pushed Georgetown all the way into that overtime, but the Hoyas ultimately just too much for Coppin State to handle in that extra five-minute period on Tuesday. The first home game for Coppin State here tonight as they host Mount St. Mary's. They will be at home on Monday night at 7 o'clock as Coppin will host the midshipmen from the U.S. Naval Academy here on Monday night inside the PEC Arena. Be sure to tune in for that one as we will have the coverage for you right here on the CSU Sports Network. Mount St. Mary's next game will be at home on November the 15th. That's next Tuesday. They will open up their home schedule against McDaniel College, and then they will travel out to California for a three-game road trip beginning at USC on November the 18th. Well, it looks like we are finally ready to roll and have something to go, and the clock's going to read 19:48, and the shot clock is going to read 18 seconds. And that is where we will start. Coppin will attack right to left. Mount St. Mary's will go left to right on your screen or on your radio dial here to start half number one. Coppin State, led by the six-year head coach, Maryland alumni national champion Juan Dixon. He is assisted by the associate head coach, John Auslander, assistant coaches Kent Auslander, Eric Skeeters, and Jermaine Dixon. The special assistant to the head coach is Marvin Bragg. And we're ready to go. Blue's going to inbound. And we're ready to roll finally as Sessoms will cross half court and start the Coppin State offense. He gets a screen from Winston. It'll be a rescreen. Now he'll find the roller. Winston going to jump stop, go up and under with the left-handed scoop. Can't get it to go. And Malik Jefferson corrals the rebound. And now Dakota LeFou will bring it up left to right for the Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers. No score. 9:24 to go on the first half game clock. LeFou driving left on Winston. Kicks it corner. Three blocked by Tark and out of play. Jalen Benjamin with the shot attempt. Tark with the rejection, 15 to shoot as Mount St. Mary's will retain possession deep in the near side corner with 15 to shoot. It'll be Benjamin to do the inbounding. They'll get it into Jefferson. Now backdoor cut, skip pass to the far side wing, three on the way. Tinsley off the back of the rim a couple of times, batted back out, and Tinsley corrals his own miss. We'll reset with LeFou, and another time. More clock issues on the far side of the floor at the scorer's table. Got to get it together over there and figure out those clock issues. On the clock, 18 seconds to shoot, and Mount St. Mary's will inbound on the far side of the floor. Benjamin over near side to LeFou, who will find the cutter, and it is a skip pass out of bounds by Bartone, and a turnover, and Coppin will take back over on possession, and now a little full court man pressure coming on Sam Sessoms from Jalen Benjamin. The Penn State transfer is going to handle the pressure, drive right, get it back to the top, and get it right back from Winston. Gets the screen. Now he'll go in. He'll stop. He shuffled his feet in a travel, and Coppin gives it right back. No score, 18:45 to play here in the first half. Mount basketball bringing it up the floor is Jalen Benjamin, guarded by Tark. He'll come off a couple of screens. He'll stop, skip it to the near side wing, and LeFou. He'll find Bartone, back to the corner, pump fake, dribble drive, underneath, and it's stolen by Blue, and it finds Sessoms. He'll find Nenda Tark. He'll come down the right side. Offensive foul First on Nendit Tark. That's an easy call. Barreled right into the defender. And standing strong to take the charge, Jalen Benjamin. And it's the first foul on Nendit Tark. First on the team. And the Mount takes back over on possession. 18-20 to play, first half. No score between the Mountaineers and the Eagles. Benjamin. Up top, LeFou. Jefferson at the right elbow. Back across, LeFou now, far side of the floor. Floater, no. Offensive rebound. Bartone puts it back up and in. 2-0 Mount St. Mary's. 17:55 to play, first half. Winston, top of the key. Trying to get the offense moving to Sessoms. Going to drive right off the rejecting of the screen, and he'll pull up and throw up an air ball from the right elbow. And another turnover from Sam Sessoms as the Mount takes back over here with 17:44 to play in the first half. Jalen Benjamin brings the basketball up the floor as he'll cross the center court logo to start the offense for the Mountaineers. He'll get it right back. No, instead it'll be LeFou driving right into the corner. Up top, Bartone. The pass over top. Tark comes away with it. Stops, finding Titus, who fumbled it. And he couldn't corral the pass. He wasn't ready for it. And another turnover for Coppin State. Benjamin finds Bartone, top of the key. Kick out, Tinsley's three. Off the front of the rim. Another offensive rebound. Jefferson right hand, no. Tipped around. Tark can't corral it. It's going to stay with Mount St. Mary's. Nothing going right for Coppin State in the first 3 minutes. 17:07 to play, and we'll get our first sub. Here comes Xavier Lipscomb, as exiting the game will be the junior Bartone. Inbounding the ball on the near side of the basket on the baseline is Dakota LeFou. Underneath to the cutting Tinsley, and the Coppin defense fell asleep. 4-0. Mount St. Mary's, it's too easy underneath on that inbound play for the Mount. Sessom's going to come off a screen from Titus. Drive hard to his right hand. Flip it up, had it blocked. And they'll keep possession underneath. Far side of the basket to inbound will be Sam Sessoms. 16:50 to play in the first half. 17 seconds to shoot for the Coppin offense. In for Winston. Return pass for Sessoms, and then back up top for Titus. He'll dribble, handoff to the Cameron Blue, who will pull up for three and knock it down. And Cameron Blue starts off 1-for-1. 4-3, Mount with a one-point lead, 16.5 to play in the first. Fumble tipped by Tarkey, comes up with the steal. The nation's leader a season ago, Euro steps, and one. Nenda Tark gives Coppin a 5-4 lead. He'll go to the free throw line for just the second time this season, where he's 1-for-1 on the year. Jalen Gibson's going to check in for Xavier Lipscomb. That didn't last long for the junior grad, or the junior guard off the bench. Tark's free throw makes him 2-for-2 on the year, and Coppin with a 2-point lead, 6-4 with 16:22 to go in the first. Gibson to the high post, and Jefferson. Jefferson doesn't drive on Winston. He had his right hand if he would have just pivoted and gone. Kick to the corner, pump fake, ball on the floor, pull up, jump shot off a couple of dribbles for Jalen Benjamin, and we're tied at 6. Next whistle will take us to our first media timeout. Winston crossing the timeline to start the offense for Coppin. He'll find Blue. Blue wants another three. Line drive shot is good for the transfer from Mississippi Valley State and Fordham. He's 2-for-2. He's got 6 points. And a block underneath by Justin Winston. 9-6 the score, 15:37 to play in the first half. That whistle takes us to the under 16 media timeout. We'll step aside and be back with more on the CSU Sports Network after this.
Imagine a place where learning pushes you further and strengthens you from mind to toe. The promise of tomorrow begins with your commitment today. Connect with people who open minds and open doors, taking you from here to there. We take pride in our legacy that prepares you for the rest of your life. Coppin State University.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, we all just got new smartphones at Cricket. Hi.
Hi.
Hola.
Hi. Hi.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Bye.
There is something greater than finishing first.
True champions stand on principles.
We fight for the right causes. We believe in the
power of teamwork, whether in rebounding, receiving, or in research.
In service and in sportsmanship.
Only a few have what it really takes.
We develop the talent. We unleash the potential.
It all boils down to this. Now
is the time. This is the place.
We are MEAC.
Back inside the PEC Arena, where Coppin State at the under 16 media timeout holds on to a 9-6 lead over the visiting Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers. Cameron Blue leads the way with 6 points for the Coppin State offense on 2 of 2 shooting. Both his shots are good from 3-point range. Ninda Tark is 1 for 1 from the floor with the and one and the free throw for 3 points and a couple of steals. The nation's leader in steals per game with 2.94 per game a season ago. And Ninda Tark was honored before the game for that honor from last year. This year coming in, he's already averaging 2.5 steals through the first 2 games of the season here in just the first week of the regular season. Mount St. Mary's basketball, 15:37 to play, a 3-point Coppin State lead. They will inbound on the left side of the basket. This time they cut off the middle, and they'll throw it in for Bartone, tipped away by Steers, who just checked in, but he couldn't come away with the steal, and it will remain Mount St. Mary's basketball. Steers coming off a double-double with a career-high 21 points and 12 rebounds. He shot 5 of 10 from the floor and 11 of 13 from the charity stripe. And once again, we got some clock issues to work out on the far side of the floor. Mount St. Mary's basketball, 15:35 to play, 18 seconds on the shot clock. And LeFou will do the inbounding. In for Benjamin. Guarded by Tark at the center court logo. Now he picks up his dribble, and he'll fire up a three, left it short, and into the hands of Justin Steers. Up ahead for Tark. He'll push the pace for Coppin. Going to try and get all the way to the rim. Took a bump, threw it up. No, Steers an offensive rebound. Power dribble. Now he's got it in trouble. Kicks it out. Sessom steps into a three. Yes! Coppin State starting off 3 for 3 from beyond the arc, and it's 12-6. Coppin doubling up the Mount with 15 minutes to play in the first half. Sam Sessoms scores his first bucket on his first try in the PEC Arena as a Coppin State Eagle. They're going to ice the screen as he rejects it and goes up on Steers, and Benjamin lays it up and in with the right hand. 12-8 the score. Sessoms now going to push it against Benjamin. Finding Steers. Back for Sessoms on a dribble handoff. Going right, finding the cutting Steers. Floater, no, too strong. Back iron. And it's rebounded by Gibson. Benjamin with the ball. Guarded by Isaiah Gross just into the game for Coppin State. Cameron Blue guarding the basketball. As it's kicked to the corner. Benjamin back across on the skip. One more into the corner for three. Short from LeFou, and it's off the mark. 4-point Coppin lead, Sam Sessoms for Steers. Back for Sessoms. Driving, finding the cutting Steers. Skip pass got away. And now Gross will send it back across to the right side. Blue going to put it on the floor. He'll pull up. He wants another one. Too strong off the back of the rim for Cameron Blue. Formerly known as Cameron Cunningham when he was at Mississippi Valley State. His first miss of the night, and it's 12-8 Coppin. 13:44 to play first half. He's guarding the basketball, and Jalen Benjamin right now. He'll drive right, switched with Sessoms, gets underneath, working on Steers, flipped it up, and it bounced all over the rim. Might have touched every single part and bounced out. Sessoms going to pull the trigger from deep, too short, left it off the front of the rim, rebounded by Tinsley. Gibson bringing it up the floor on the right wing. Going to drive baseline into the double team. Skip to the left corner. Three on the way. LeFou that time connects. And it's a one-point game. 12-11, 13-05 to play first half. Steers with the basketball. Going to get it to Tark. Steers going to rescreen. Now get it on the slip. Up with the left hand. And one for the big man, Justin Steers. He'll have a chance to get three the old-fashioned way. Coppin up three, 12:54 to go. Here comes Alex Rojas and Mike Hood. And Malik Jefferson will check back in. Lipscomb will check back in. And number 23 checks in for the first time this season, Josh Reeves. Checks in for the first time this year. Steers, a 76% shooter on the year, 13-17 from the line. Can't connect to get three. Coppin hangs on to a three-point lead with 12:50 to go. 14-11. Lipscomb skips it across to the far wing. LeFou being harassed by Sessoms. Finds Jefferson. Couldn't get it back on the handoff. Now Jefferson's going to put it on the floor. Find Reeves. Back door for Tinsley, now to the corner on the extra pass, three, and we are tied as LeFou relocates and hits the triple. Tied at 14, 12:25 to play first half. Both teams starting to connect on some shots from deep. Tark gonna drive left, get it up with the left hand, and Tark able to get the scoop to fall. He was looking for an one with the contact. 16-14, Coppin back on top by two. Tinsley, pull up, straight away from the free throw line, and he connects to tie us at 16. Next whistle will take us to the under 12 media timeout, 11:57 to play first half. Steers gonna start the offense for Tark. They'll put it on the floor, left hand, now find Mike Hood. The hero on Tuesday to force overtime against Georgetown gives it up for Steers. He thought about three. Gonna go on Jefferson, and Jefferson's gonna be called for a reach. That foul's gonna be on the floor, and that'll take us to the under 12 media timeout here in half number one. We'll step aside and be back with more. You're listening to Coppin State Men's Basketball on the CSU Sports Network.
Since 1837, historically black colleges and universities have been fulfilling their purpose to educate and empower. Since 2009, the Home Depot's Retool Your School Campus Improvement Grant Program has also been powered by a purpose to update, upgrade, and uplift HBCU campuses. Today, 44 million votes, $4.1 million, and 147 grants later, we remain inspired by the people, the passion, and the power of HBCUs to continue our purpose. Learn more at RetoolYourSchool.com.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
As technology is always innovating, we're always innovating the way we care. At MedStar Health, we have groundbreaking surgery that can save your life and groundbreaking therapy that gets you back to your life. MedStar Health, it's how we treat people.
Welcome back inside PEC Arena at the under 12 media timeout. We are all tied at 16. As you take a look at the six-year head coach from the University of Maryland, a former national champion in 2002, Juan Dixon, in his sixth year as the head coach here at Coppin State. He's 42-110 all time, and he leads Coppin State to the MEAC title game. They were a win away as the seventh seed in the conference last season. He also played 7 years in the NBA, mostly for his hometown Washington Wizards. Juan Dixon and his team looking to get back to that MEAC title game and play for that ever-elusive conference title. Coppin State hasn't been to the NCAA tournament since 2008, and coincidentally, that's the first time the Mount and Coppin State met, and the Mount and Mount St. Mary's got their first ever tournament win in Dayton, Ohio, as part of the first four matchup between these two sides. This is the fifth meeting all time. Coppin's 0-4 against Mount St. Mary's. Coppin with the ball tied at 16, 10 to shoot. Tark underneath steers, corrals the pass. He slipped, and now will be whistled for a travel, and he has some protesting to do. Justin Steers was ejected from the game late in overtime against Georgetown after they were already down 10, and the game was pretty much over from that point. Finding the cutting Reeves. Steers going to be whistled for a foul, and Reeves is going to go to the line for the first time this season. Tied at 16, 11-18 to play first half. The junior guard from Hamden, Connecticut, will go to the charity stripe for the first time this year. First free throw, no good. We will remain tied at 16 as Reeves can't connect on the first free throw. Mount St. Mary's looking to get themselves back on track after losing to West Virginia on the road on Monday. As he misses both free throws, we remain tied at 16. Copping up the floor to Alex Rojas. Now to Steers for Hood. He'll drive left, throw up a right-handed floater. No tip from Steers. Got it to go. Mount St. Mary's wants an offensive basket interference because Steers grabbed the net on his way through. And I think they got a case for it, but the referees don't call it. Coppin gets away with one and a two-point lead with 10:49 to play. High post for Jefferson, back for Benjamin. Back up top. Now for Benjamin. Skip pass to the corner. Lipscomb back up top, Reeves. High post, Jefferson putting it on the floor. Two steps blocked by Justin Steers. He got a hand on it. Offensive rebound, kick out, whistle. And a shot clock violation, which should not be the case. Steers blocked it, but Jefferson got it off the rim as he muscled it through for a moment. And Cameron Blue is going to check back into the contest. And Dan Engelsted is upset over on the Mount St. Mary's sideline. The fifth-year head coach and a graduate of Mount St. Mary's has an excellent case here with the officials as he's letting our officiating crew know it. And now we'll get a stoppage in play. They're not going to come look at it. Coppin State basketball up by two, 18-16, 10:22 to go as they cross the timeline and start off the offense. Hood for Sessoms. Getting the screen. He'll keep it himself. Now kick to the corner. Extra pass. Blue was on the line and out of play. Didn't know where he was in the corner. Too close to that sideline. Another Coppin turnover. It's their fifth of the contest. Up by two, 10-11 to go, clock rolling in the first half. Lipscomb for Tinsley, straight away. Back for Lipscomb on the wing, near side. Up top, Jefferson in the corner. LeFou wants three, give it to him. Mount St. Mary's regains a one-point lead, 19-18. These two in-state rivals going back and forth here in the first half. Sessoms driving, Euro stepping, no, got it back off the block, Steers! Underneath, flipping it up and in. Justin Steers kicking off his redshirt senior year with a bang here, continuing his hot start that he had against Georgetown. Coppin back on top, reach-in foul coming on Cameron Blue as František Bartone gets set to check back into the contest for Malik Jefferson. 9:31 to play, Coppin up 20-19. Steers with 6 points early to tie the Coppin lead with Cameron Blue. And now Steers will check out, and the sophomore transfer from Oral Roberts, number 33, Luka Tkalvich, will check in for Coppin State, the 6'11" sophomore in the game for the Eagles. He's on the ball right now guarding Benjamin. Underneath, Sessoms got his hand on it. Missed the shot, did Bartone. Kick out, one more Benjamin, now guarded by Hood. Back across LeFou. He's guarded closely by Rojas. 10 to shoot. Up top, Blue pokes it away and out of bounds. Mount St. Mary's will take over at midcourt with 9 seconds on the shot clock, 9:11 to go here in the first half. A 20-19 Coppin advantage. Bartone will inbound. To the backcourt it goes for Benjamin. 7 to shoot. He's got to go. He's going to put it on the deck. Pull up from the left. Free throw line extended from the elbow and knock it down. 21-20. Mount's got the lead. Under 9 to play now. Cameron Blue gets it right back on the handoff. Now gets a screen underneath. Skip pass Rojas for Sessoms up top. He traveled. Shuffled his feet. Nice find by Takalvich in the corner. And the extra pass just sped Sessoms up a little too much. And a one-point Mount St. Mary's lead, 21-20. They take back over with 8:48 to play in the first half. And here comes Jefferson back in for Bartone. Malik Jefferson in his fifth year here at Mount St. Mary's. Back into the game. He's got 6 points early. About halfway through this first half, a little bit more. Back for Jefferson. Not a threat to shoot it from out there. He'll get it on the handoff to Reeves now. Turning the corner over to Kalvich, too strong. Hood comes down with the board. Hood had a chance to pop the three, doesn't take it. Now got Jefferson in the air on the step back, but couldn't do it against that 6'11 frame of Malik Jefferson. Now he'll put it on the deck. Attack Tinsley. Flip it up left hand. Roll shot, no. Batted around. Diving on the floor. Tinsley. Now Jefferson comes up with it for Mount St. Mary's. LeFou's three on the right wing is connecting. 4-point Mount lead, 24-20. Tark on the bench for Coppin State. Might start thinking about getting him back in. Sessoms off the screen. Takalvich is going to be called for an illegal screen. And that'll take us to the under 8 media timeout. It's a 4-point Mount St. Mary's lead. We'll take the break with them and be back in just moments after this on the CSU Sports Network.
Please continue to hold.
People who come to cricket stay with cricket.
With my cricket plan, everything is consistent. It's always going to be the same price. No worries.
Cricket is easy, it's affordable, customer service is top-notch. That's why I've been with them for so long.
I got my phone from Cricket and it's amazing. As a journalist, I use it for basically everything.
Great phones, great deals. Now that's a story. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Beautiful day in Baltimore, where most people probably know that Geico could save them money on car insurance, right? Well, could help them save on boat insurance, too.
Okay. Request to come ashore.
Geico.
Back at the under 8 media timeout, 7:52 on the first half game clock. Coppin State up 24-20. Mount St. Mary's up on Coppin State 24-20 here in half number one. If you're just joining us, I'm Kyle Borg here with you on the radio and on our live stream coverage of Coppin State men's basketball's home opener. Mount St. Mary's 0-1 of the year, Coppin 0-2, both sides searching for that elusive first victory on their young season. College basketball kicked off on Monday. Coppin at Charlotte falling 82-59. And Mount St. Mary's at West Virginia losing 76-58 in that one. They were led by Jalen Benjamin's 18 points, while Coppin State against Georgetown was led by the double-double of Justin Steers is 21 points, 12 rebounds on 50% shooting. Sam Sessom's double-double of 16 points and 10 assists as you take a look at Dan Engelstead, the fifth-year head coach at Mount St. Mary's, where he is 46-71. They have since left the NEC Conference and joined the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference for this season. As you saw, that last conference title was in 2021. They had six as a 30-year member of the NEC. A three-point try is well off the front of the rim and short. Coppin corrals the rebound. Tark quickly ahead in the corner. Rojas, you bet. Alex Rojas, 60% shooting on the year. He was 3 of 5 from deep coming in, make him 4 of 6 now on the season. And it's a one-point Mount lead. Tark, another steal. He'll find the trailer blue and throw it out of bounds. Timeout, Juan Dixon. It'll be a 30-second timeout. We're going to pause and take that 30-second timeout with him. We'll be right back on the CSU Sports Network. Out of the Coppin State timeout, it's 24-23. Mountaineers have a lead, 7:10 to go here in half number one. Mount St. Mary's with the basketball, going to inbound near sideline in the backcourt. And they'll get it into Benjamin, who will be guarded by Nenda Tark. Coppin down by one here. Mount looking to add to their lead out of the horn set, tipped away. Almost backcourt violation. Now Benjamin, a wide open lane to the basket. And I think Winston got a piece of it off the glass. Tark for Winston. In the corner, Blue near side. Back for Winston. Return pass on the handoff for Blue. Going to drive left baseline. Slip. Kept his footing though. Winston wants three. Short off front iron. And into the hands of LeFou. Now for Benjamin. Hooked Rojas, but are they going to get Rojas for a block? They are. Rojas picks up his first, fifth on the team. Foul occurred before Rojas got hooked. Here comes Bartone and Lipscomb as Benjamin checks out for the first time, and Jefferson will return to the bench for Mount St. Mary's. 6.5 minutes to play, a one-point Mount St. Mary's lead. Here comes Justin Steers. He'll check in for Alex Rojas. In for Bartone, just got it off the fingertips. And we'll start the offense. Left wing, back up top, Bartone, straight away, gonna drive right, find the backdoor cutter, and LeFou almost got it to go. Steers comes down with the board. Sessoms, quickly ahead, Blue, puts it on the floor off the head fake, gets to the rim, throws it away as he was trying to find the relocating Nenda Tark. And Blue's gonna check out of the game for Mike Hood, and he knows it. After that turnover, it is the ninth turnover of the half for Coppin, a team that's averaging 14.5 turnovers a game. 1 point Mount lead, 24-23, 6:05 to play first half. Gibson almost lost it. Now gets it on the handoff for Lipscomb, who finds LeFou. Step back on the baseline. Shot off the front rim, no. Tark picks it up, 3-on-2 if he goes. Finds Sessoms. Lost the handle, now for Winston. He'll jab and go right. Jump stop underneath, right-handed lay-in is good. And Coppin back on top, 25-24. 5:37 to play, first half. Up top, Tinsley. Trying to find Gibson. Couldn't get it to him, so he gets it to Lipscomb instead on the far side wing. Tinsley underneath, tripped up Steers, second personal, sixth team. Next one's going to put Coppin in the bonus with 5:20 to play and a couple of subs in Benjamin and J.D. Cordelia in for the first time today for Mount St. Mary. Steers comes out to protect him, and Tkalvich will come back in. Lipscomb and Gibson out for Mount St. Mary's. 5:20 to go. Reset the shot clock to 20 seconds, and it's a one-point Coppin lead. Inbound on the baseline. In for Bartone on the lob. Finding Benjamin, who will drive. Had it stripped away. Ball loose. Tkalvich on the floor. Comes up with it. Tark ahead for Sessoms. Two on two. He'll drive in. Left hand. Sam Sessoms with 5 points in the first half and a Coppin 27-24 advantage. 4:55 to play. Benjamin across for LeFou. Finds Bartone. Back for LeFou. Bartone thought about it instead. Gets it out. Benjamin connects to tie the game at 27. Timeout called by Mount St. Mary's. We're going to keep it right here. Tied at 27 here in half number one. 4:40 to play in the first half. And both these teams are trading punches here to open up this ball game. Leading the way with all scorers is Dakota LeFou with 12 on 50% shooting from the floor early on. Blue and Steers lead the way with 6 apiece for Coppin. Sessoms with 5, Tark with 5, Rojas 3, Winston 2. Coppin 9 first half turnovers. They force 7 of their own, but they are 3 of their last 4 from the field, while Mount St. Mary's is just 1 of their last 5. .440 to go here in the first half. Sam Sessoms will take the basketball for Coppin State. Brings it across. Coppin going to look to take back the lead. He'll go right off the screen. Backing down, Benjamin wants a fadeaway. Jump shot, nothing but net for Sam Sessoms. 29-27, Coppin up 2. Mount basketball. Benjamin drives left into the double team. Kicks it back out. Skip pass Benjamin. Extra pass Tinsley. Driving left to the middle. Now to the left corner. A 3 on the way. Short. Offensive rebound Tinsley. Up top, Benjamin wants one from 35. Too strong. Bartone tipped it to himself, but we're going to get a whistle and a foul. Is that going to be on Tkalvich? It is. And that takes us to the under 4 media timeout. We'll be back in just moments after this on the CSU Sports Network. Welcome back inside the PEC arena at the under 4 media timeout. Coppin's up 29-27. And now we are joined by Coppin State Athletic Director Derek Carter. Thank you for joining us here on the broadcast.
Thank you so much. Glad to be here. Great game. Rainy day.
It was a very rainy day, and it's kind of raining here inside the PEC arena. Both these teams hot start shooting. Coppin 52% from the floor, 57% from deep. Oh, the threes have been falling for Coppin tonight.
That's great. You know, we kind of tend to live by the three, so if we're going to shoot them, we need to make them. So that's good.
4 of 7 officially half.
Good.
And they were hitting threes at Georgetown on Tuesday night, but overtime, that extra five-minute period just wasn't too kind to Coppin State.
Yeah, I kind of ran out of gas a little bit. But, you know, you watch that game and you really say we kind of let one get away.
And Mike Hood was the hero at the end of that, got the offense.
Sure.
It just bounced right to him. And he hit that three, his only made field goal of the game, too.
That's unbelievable, isn't it?
If you're only going to hit one, it might as well be to force overtime,
right? Let
that
be the one. Let that be the one. Exactly.
A 1-1 free throw opportunity for Malik Jefferson, and he cannot connect. Mount St. Mary's 0-for-3 at the free throw line here in half number one. Coppin's got a 2-point advantage. And they will look to add on to that at this possession. But with basketball season underway, women got started on Monday here at home. Unfortunately, couldn't quite get there against Pittsburgh. They came back late in that one, but Pittsburgh pulled away. And then the home opener for the men, and basketball season's in full swing.
It's here. It's here. And we're excited about the season for both teams. We'll see how the women do tonight in Charlotte. And hopefully the men will come out on top tonight.
Both men and women are looking for their first wins of the season. Of course, the women only playing game number two. There's a deep three on the way. Offensive rebound for Coppin State and Justin Winston as he'll swing it across. As we will get an update on the women's score here in just a moment, as Sessom's going to pull a three. No, couldn't get it to go. Rebound, Mount St. Mary's. It is 57-38 late in the fourth, and it looks like Charlotte's going to come away victorious at home against the Lady Eagles. Okay. There's a pull-up jump shot, and we're tied at 29. So, yeah, 57-38, and it's been a tough last three quarters, it looks like, from the box score for Coppin State.
Is that right?
Yeah, 9 points in the second, 5 in the third, just 9 in the fourth, and they had a 15-7 lead at the end of one.
Oh, okay.
But that Charlotte team is tough.
Sure, sure. No, it's a tough team. We'll have to talk to Coach Woods and kind of get some details as to what happened in the final three quarters.
The women will be back at home on Wednesday morning at 11 a.m.
Yes, that's a big day. That's our education day, in which we're probably going to have just a little bit north of 3,000 elementary school students here on Wednesday for the game versus Georgetown.
I love that pretty much everybody in college basketball, at least on the women's side, really does do one of those field trip games.
Yeah.
And it's always a big key or a big game wherever you go.
Oh, it's huge. And I've been into some. It's the most noise I've heard in an arena.
And nothing better than getting out of school as a Coppin State turnover on the travel from Sessoms.
Yeah.
But I almost wish the men would have a game like that throughout Division
I. Yeah, we're talking about it perhaps for next year. It's like you said. It's more common on the women's side, but there's no reason you can't do it on the men's
exactly.
side, too. Yeah.
And the last time that we had a broadcast with the men, they were in the MEAC championship game. That's the last time we got to talk to you on the air. Unfortunately, they just couldn't beat that Norfolk State Spartans team, a tough team, and they're going to be tough to beat
again. Tough this year. The MEAC, it's going to be great when we get into MEAC competition in January. It's a lot of good teams. We're going to be in the mix, but it's going to be a lot of competition this year.
And you know what? Early on in the non-conference season, NC Central gave Virginia all they could handle. SC State only lost at South Carolina by three the other night. So, like you said, a very competitive Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference this year, and that's great for the conference and for basketball.
No, it is. You know, we ask for respect as a conference.
Tark connects on a deep three. Coppin up three.
And that's why it's important for the MEAC as a whole. When we play these non-conference games, we have to get our wins because it strengthens our overall conference rating.
And there's a steal from Blue. Almost lost the handle. Got a right-handed layup. Coppin's up five, under a minute to go here in the first half. And you know what? The schedule road-wise, about the same as it was last year for this men's team, but more local games. They're playing pretty much the entire state of Maryland.
No, we made an intentional effort. Clearly, we play a lot of the non-conference games for revenue generation. But we made a conscious effort to reduce our geographical footprint, and we really attacked the local schools and not too many long trips. And it should be a favorable schedule for us to go into conference play.
About a three-second difference, shot and game clocks. Coppin up 34-32. They have not led at the half this year. 10 to shoot. Sessom's going to spin middle. He'll drive blocked from behind and out of bounds. Coppin will keep possession. But are they going to turn the shot clock back on, or are they going to let it go off? I think they're going to have to look at it and see if there was a change of possession. And if there was, then the shot clock will be turned off and Coppin can hold for one. If not, they're going to have about 5 seconds to shoot the ball here at the end of the half. But we're really looking forward to that game the day after Thanksgiving at Maryland, I'm sure. We'll be there to cover that one. And then on December the 6th, we're going to get to travel down to NC State as well to cover that. And then, of course, all the local games against Towson, Loyola Maryland, George Washington, George Mason. I mean, Richmond not too terribly far.
No, Richmond's not far.
And that's a quality schedule, especially with Towson, because people are saying Towson is a team that come tournament time, if they are able to get to the tournament, they're not a team that any Power 5 conference is going to want to see.
That's what I hear, so we'll see.
Shot at the buzzer. Good if it goes to tie, in and out for Jalen Benjamin. So Coppin up 34-32 at the half, their first lead at the half on this young season. Well, we will step aside and send it to commercial here and then be back with more from our half, including our interview with assistant coach Eric Skeeters. But we want to thank Coppin State Athletic Director Derek Carter for joining us here tonight.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Look forward to a great second half.
Coppin State leads 34-32 at the break here this evening. Again, their first lead of the season at the half. We'll step aside and be back in just moments after this on the CSU Sports Network.
Imagine a place where learning pushes you further and strengthens you from mind to toe. The promise of tomorrow begins with your commitment today. Connect with people who open minds and open doors, taking you from here to there. We take pride in our legacy that prepares you for the rest of your life. Coppin State University.
I'm here with Nanda Tark and Nanda.
Back really inside PEC Arena, where Coppin State has their first halftime lead of the season, 35-32. We are now joined by assistant coach Eric Skeeters. Coach, thanks for joining us here yet again. Your team's got the halftime lead. Shots are falling just under 50% from the floor in that first half.
Got a rebound. They got 10 offensive rebounds with 3 minutes to go in the half. We just got to do a better job. Justin Steers gave us great minutes rebounding, but he got a quick cheap. We got him out of the game with two fouls. So we got to do a better job taking care of the ball, too. Our turnovers are unforced versus theirs. We have seven steals, so we're trying to guard and get deflection, getting our hands on ball where we care. We got to take care of the ball.
Absolutely. You talk about those 11 turnovers. Your defense has been able to force 10 in that first half. And like you said, getting your hand on the basketball, deflecting it, tipping it away, and even when you don't come away with a steal, you're forcing it late in the shot clock.
Correct. And seven steals, so we just got to do a better job. Second half is going to be on us because they're not in front of our bench.
And 24 of the 32 from Mount St. Mary's have come from LeFou and Benjamin. Coach,
yeah,
what can you do to slow them down?
Coming out. I mean, we got to know who the shooters are and recognize them earlier, but do a better job of recognizing and running them off, containing, and not give them second chances.
Coach, key in the second half to continue the lead and come
defense,
away victorious.
Defense, rebound.
Defense and rebounding. Coach, thanks for joining us here at the half. Go join your team in the locker room. Thank you. Assistant coach Eric Skeeters here at the break, giving us his halftime thoughts on his team's first half performance. And they have a 34-32 advantage here at the break. We'll go ahead and step aside again one quick time here and be back in just a few moments after this on the CSU Sports Network.
Imagine a place where learning pushes you further and strengthens you from mind to toe. The promise of tomorrow begins with your commitment today. Connect with people who open minds and open doors, taking you from here to there. We take pride in our legacy that prepares you for the rest of your life. Coppin State University.
Hey Eagle fans, I'm here with Nanda Tark, and Nanda, I'm really eager to have this chance to just talk basketball with you and catch up. It's been a pretty eventful week so far. You earned MEAC preseason first team all-conference prior to earning MEAC first team all-conference for the 2022 season. Alongside, you led the nation with 2.94 steals a game. So a lot of accolades there. And just what's your keys to success as a player within the MEAC?
just try to help my team win any way possible. I don't really play for stats or play for accolades. Like, I try to let those things come naturally as a result of my play. But, like, for me, it's not about the stats. So whether I score a lot, rebound a lot, assist a lot, whatever the case is, like, defend, I just want to help the team win. And however I can.
Back here at the half from the PEC Arena, where Coppin is up 34-32. Let's update some scores from around the NCAA while we have some time. At the half, number one,
more so anticipating reads in the flight of the ball.
I think it's a little bit of both. I think off the ball, it's reading eyes, like ball movement, where he's going to go, like those kind of things where you anticipate what's happening. And then on the ball as well, like timing their dribble up. But I think it's a combination of both where it's like they got to think quick and then move fast as well. So it's just a combination of both, and I just try to use that to the best of my abilities.
That's wrong. And, you know, it also made me think of a thought of the four buzzer beaters that you've hit this past season.
That's the ball game. Nanda Tark at the buzzer.
So exciting to watch in those heated moments where you have to hit game winners.
Pulls up. Good. At the buzzer.
One of them was a really big game in the playoffs against the first seed to really get to that chip. So tell me a little bit about that.
Shoot. I love those moments. Honestly, the way some of them turned out is similar in all of them, where someone's at the free throw line and like they miss one, and now the game's tied up. It's like, okay, well, go win the game, you know.
Can't foul.
But nothing, there's nothing too much going in my head. There's no pressure. My coaches and my teammates all trusted me, and they all put faith in me to make a play. And, you know, when you have that backing on top of the work that you put in, it's like,
unbelievable.
You've done everything. Trust everything that you've done to get to this point and live with the result. And if the people behind me supporting me are living with the result, I can live with the result, so make or miss.
This is so crazy to watch, like, from an exterior, because those plays are huge.
Yeah.
Let's get a little bit into some of the team culture now. I know you've compiled a team of returners along with some new transfers. So how are you guys looking so far this season?
Man, I think we're good. I think we're good. You know, we play this week, and we got a lot of returners, which is good, set the foundation. But we also have a lot of impact transfers that are going to make some noise for us. We've had two scrimmages, won them both, you know, which is just a part of getting better every day. And that's what we intend on doing. We don't get too high or too low, but we know, because we know what the end goal is, but we know you got to celebrate your small wins, like, going forward. So as we're looking good, and I think as these games start and continue to go on, we'll continue to look even better.
Nice. I know. I can't wait. And it's going to be really a movie that what you guys are cultivating.
Yeah.
Last question I have. You've gotten a taste of what it's like getting to the MEAC championship and fell short. So as a team, what are some things you guys need to narrow in on the court to really secure that win and make it to the big things?
Shoot, I say scoring the ball, because last year in the championship game, we stopped them. We got a lot of stops. I think they had 23 points at halftime, maybe 20, something like that. Like, we were getting a lot of stops. It was just a matter of now us scoring and capitalizing off getting stops, because at the end of the day, like, defense is a standard here. Like, in order to play here, you got to play defense. So that's a given. But now it's like the other side, scoring the ball. And I struggle with that, and the rest of the team did as well. And then the second part is, like, adversity. When a team makes a run, like, how do we stop that? And I feel like that's what we struggled with throughout the whole year of last year. But like I said, our scrimmages this year, we've had two where we were down double digits, and we found a way to stop the bleeding and end up on top. So I feel like, you know, we still were scoring 70s and 80s points. And so, like, scoring, it seems like we corrected those two things. And now if we just continue to mesh and grow, I think we should be fine.
Basketball is all a game of runs and just capitalizing off of that. Yeah. And, you know, I'm just so excited to see what you are have in store for us this season, because you've made a lot of noise within the MEAC, but also within the NCAA. So, really eager to just be a part of the story and just see what you're cultivating.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, everybody, Nanda Tark, Coppin State men's basketball, stay tuned with what they're cultivating.
Hi!
Hi!
Oh, we all just got new smartphones at Cricket.
Hi!
Hi!
Hola!
Hi!
Hi!
Okay, bye!
Bye!
As technology is always innovating, we're always innovating the way we care. At MedStar Health, we have groundbreaking surgery that can save your life, and groundbreaking therapy that gets you back to your life. MedStar Health, it's how we treat people.
Make it happen. If we ain't gonna get it with this.
dead, we'll take it cap. Bussin' off, dustin' off, it's soft. Against money with the biggest mouth, so let's talk this nigga. Come on. I guess he never made a sound. Way too f***ing hard and he getting bust down.
Yeah. Wanna be killers.
Get at me, dog.
Yeah. Wanna kill us.
Get at me, dog.
Yeah. Want the bread.
Get at me, dog.
What?
Yeah. With the dirt.
Yeah. Wanna be killers.
Get at me, dog.
Yeah. Wanna kill us.
Get at me, dog.
Yeah. Want the bread.
Get at me, dog.
What?
Now it's there.
Don't get too good for certain. Some hurting. What you know? Robbing. Jerking. Sticking. Cause they deserve it. When money got murdered. They know he died slow. Cause they hurt it. The game blew up the spot in a while. And the mob ain't got shot in a while.
You know?
Just takes a light up. Off the night up. Blow everything in sight up. Look around and I have your ass right up. In the Mexican. He wasn't able to stand. I guess that I'm disabled a man with a wave of the hand. The days are longer and it seems like I'm facing time. I've got a lot of dreams, but I'm not really chasing mine. I soak it all up like a sitting fly. Nowadays, getting by is nothing more than the occasional meal and getting high. I live to die, that's where I'm headed. Let your man hold something. Now it's all about you can get it.
Just wanna be killers.
Get at me, dog.
Just wanna kill us.
Get at me, dog.
Yeah. Want the bread.
Get at me, dog.
What?
Yeah. Come on. When in the back, let your face down. Lucky that you're breathing, but you're dead from the waist down. It's on your mind, talking that you be talking. And I bet you wish you never got hit, cause you'd be walking. It happens, and you done did your dirt. Just wonder how the f*** you hit your skirt right under the eye. That's a surprise to the guy. One of they man was a f*** in the sky. But cats and all the more hits and slaughter more kids. Let me holler at you, yo, that Baltimore. Yeah, you know I mean, I'm just robbing to eat. And there's at least 1,000 of us like me mobbing the street. When we starve and we eat, whatever's there. Come on, you know the cold in the street, whatever's fair. Blood stains and chalk means your man couldn't walk after the talk about him knocking on 11:33 in New York.
I'ma win. I'ma get this money. I'ma live. First in my family with some legal bread. Had to risk it all just to win big. I can stack them hundreds to the roof. I ain't stopping till they stack to the moon. Without me, my family wouldn't have food. Anybody go against me, gotta lose. 90s baby, but I get to that money like 86 again. Lost pops and fell off, we back rich again. Gotta thank God for that prison bid. Music got us looking like the family selling bricks again. Been on tour, been on TV, own business. Still a pull up on you with that stick and flip the whip you in. You don't wanna hear about indictments in the case I caught him. Quit listening, free my mar, he innocent. I was in the county indigent, now my pendant lit. Flood me, they go crazy about that real. Used to be a young follower, I was ignorant. If you don't want me to go anywhere with that. I drop a bird on your head. That chopper blow a third of the nerves out your head. Talking cat, and we murdering that man. When they put them teddy bears on the curb for your ass, you lost. Look me in my eyes, I'ma win. I'ma get this money, I'ma live. First in my family with some legal bread. Had to risk it all just to win big. I can stack them hundreds to the roof. I ain't stopping till they stack to the moon. Without me, my family wouldn't have food. Anybody go against me, gotta lose. 700K in here, and my bag in this room. But it's only for your eyes, while your man's in this room.
You can enjoy this 20 minutes of basketball that you have left here in this one. Turk, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me. It was a pleasure.
It was a pleasure meeting you. Coppin State alumni, Turk Mott joining us on the broadcast this evening, and a first shot. And one, going to go foul on Cameron Blue. Jalen Benjamin connects for two. He'll go to the line for one more, and he can give the Mount the lead as Cameron Blue picks up his second, and he'll have a word with his head coach on the sideline upcoming. Mount St. Mary's 0-for-3 at the free throw line here this evening, looking to connect for the first time from the line this or tonight. Tied at 34. Jalen Benjamin picked up his 14th bucket or 14th point on that last shot. He'll look to make it 15 here with the free throw. Coppin State has only shot two free throws as that's in and out. 0-for-4 go the Mountaineers from the line. Tied at 34, early second half. Coppin going left to right now on your screen and on your radio dial. Winston almost turned it over, got it right back. Sessoms going to drive right, get some separation, pull up, and that's what Sam Sessoms does. The Penn State transfer had a good career over 2 years in the Big Ten, And he's filling it up here early on in the November for Coppin State as they force a miss and get the rebound with Winston. Sessom's bringing it up. Thought about it, now going to drive in, left-handed layup. Oh, he left it short off the front of the rim. Rebound to Tinsley and Mount St. Mary's. Benjamin lost it out of bounds. They're going to say it got tipped. And Mount St. Mary's will keep possession of the basketball with 19:06 to play. 22 to shoot. They'll inbound on the far side of the basket. Underneath on the baseline, it will be Dakota LeFou to do the inbounding for Mount St. Mary's. They're going to lob it up top for Malik Jefferson, who will give it right back to the inbounder. Gross starting this, or now into the game in the second half here for Cameron Blue, who just picked up his second foul. Sessoms on the run, missed the layup with the right hand. This time he was too strong after leaving the last one short. Back comes Mount St. Mary's. Tinsley, handoff for LeFou. Back for Bartone. Finding the back door underneath Jefferson. Gross going to sell it and get the charge call. Good take from Isaiah Gross, the redshirt sophomore and former Mr. Maryland, or Maryland Mr. Basketball. He was first team All-State as a senior at Eleanor Roosevelt, and he takes the charge here and gets Coppin the ball back up by two. 36-34, Eagles lead, 18:40 to play. Tark will bring it up slowly for Coppin State, and he'll be guarded by Dakota LeFou. They're going to find Sessoms again. Almost lost it. Now we'll put it on the floor. Give it back, Tark. Miscommunication with Daniel Titus. Back up top, Winston wants three, connecting. Justin Winston, the senior out of Robert Morris, and St. Bonaventure connects on the three. 39-34, a five-point Eagle advantage. Mountaineer basketball, far side of the floor, moving right to left. They're going to get it back in the middle. Skip pass left corner. A three and a touch foul on Isaiah Gross. They're going to say he got him on the arm. It's a shooting foul. Second team, first on Gross. The Cardinals sit in basketball, fouling a three-point shooter. And Isaiah Gross just couldn't get away with that one. Here comes three free throws for Dakota LeFou, his first three free throws on the season. And he is now 1-for-1 from the line on the year. Didn't shoot a lot of free throws did this Mount St. Mary's team against West Virginia to open the season. And now they are 1-for-5 here tonight. Make it 2-for-6 as LeFou connects on that one. Mount St. Mary's picked to finish 10th out of 11 as they were the 11th team added to the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference for this year. Of course, preseason favorite Iona, led by Rick Pitino, picked to win that conference again for the third straight season. But the Mount, after 30 years in the Northeast Conference, decided that it was time to move conferences, so they joined the MAAC and will look to make some noise in that conference, picked to finish second to last. It's a two-point game as all three free throws go down for LeFou. 39-37, Winston. Corner for Titus, going to come hard off the screen. Drive in, had it knocked away in a turnover. Up for Benjamin. Going to the middle, now on the wing. He'll back it out. He's guarded by Winston. Top of the key, gets the screen. Here's the switch, now guarded by Titus. Driving hard to the basket, kicks it back out. Tinsley, 10 to shoot, back for Benjamin. 40 feet from the basket, 17-20 to play. They're down two. Now he'll get inside, whistling a foul on Daniel Titus, and Mount St. Mary's is getting to the free throw line early in this second half and really putting the pressure on Coppin State. Titus picks up his first. And it'll be free throws for Benjamin. Sinks it, and Benjamin is now 1-for-2 on the night. He is a 70% free throw shooter coming into the contest this evening. And he cuts the lead to one. And he'll tie things up at 39. 17-17 to play. Second half, Winston will walk it up for Coppin State. He's guarded by Bartow. Tark off the screen, throws it up with the left hand, and gets fouled by LeFou. That is his first personal, so Nenda Tark getting to the line for the second time tonight. He is now 2-for-2 on the season from the line, so one of the MEAC leaders in that category a season ago has been quiet at the line this year. This will be free throw attempts number 3 and 4 on the year, numbers 2 and 3 here tonight. And Nenda sinks the first free throw. A member of the first team all-conference last year, all-defensive team, of course, led the nations in steals. We've already talked about that this evening, and he is a preseason pick to be on the first team all-MEAC at the end of the year. And now Tark, who bobbled. He bobbled the catch because he wasn't paying attention and then threw it back to the referee. That is just a mental lapse. Once you have it, you can't throw it back unless the officials are going to ask for it. So that's just a mental error on Nenda Tark. So a violation on Nenda, which will go down as a free throw miss, his first on the year. And now Winston's going to have to get something taken care of. Might have gotten cut somewhere. Looks like he might have some blood on his leg. So 40-39, Coppin up one, but not what you wanted if you're Nenda Tark and the Eagles. The redshirt sophomore in his third year with this program out of Bullis High School, where he was a 1,000-point scorer. And the Gaithersburg, Maryland native played a year with his older brother, Anthony, who was on a couple of G League, Summer League rosters, a G League roster and a Summer League roster this season. Don't believe that he made a team. But and now they're going to send Steers in for Winston so he can get going here. And now they're going to send him back to the locker room to get something taken care of. I'm not sure what the issue is, but we're back underway. 17 minutes to play in the second half, and Coppin's up by one on the Mountaineers. Mountaineer basketball, Tinsley over for Reeves. Drives back to the wing. Pass tipped. Free throw line. Ball underneath to Tinsley. Nice defense from Tark to avoid fouling. But Tinsley connects anyway. Back for Titus, who will bring it up for Coppin. 41-40. Back and forth we go. Mount St. Mary's with the lead. In the corner. Thrown away by Sam Sessoms. 13th turnover for Coppin in the ballgame. They average through two games on the year 14.5. They're also forcing 14.5 turnovers and only have forced 11 here so far in this one. 16:20 to go. Benjamin comes off the screen. Tinsley over for Bartone. Back for Benjamin. He drives left, hesitates, gets inside, kick to the corner. Three strong. Rebound Sessoms. Here comes Sessoms for Steers. He directs traffic for Tark. Back for Sam. Thought about it. Steers going to split the defense. Bobbled it and turned it over again. Reeves up the floor with the left hand. Finding Tinsley. He wants three. Short. Titus finding Blue. Blue driving in. Scoop to the hoop. And gets the left-handed lay-in with some extracurricular words for Benjamin after the lay-in. 42-41, Cameron Blue has double-digit points now. He's the first Eagle to do so. He's got 10. He's also 4 or 5 from the floor. Nice shooting night from Cameron Blue. Benjamin to the rim. Oh, he missed the chip shot. Can't miss those if you're Mount St. Mary's. Sessoms thought about it. Now for Tark. He wants three. Going to be short off the front of the rim. Benjamin corrals it and brings it up for Mount St. Mary's. Far side of the floor on the wing. Gonna reject the screen, get underneath, find Bartone with a two-handed flush. 43-42, Mount St. Mary's. Timeout one, Dixon into the media timeout. We go under 16 to play, 43-42. Mount St. Mary's has the advantage with 14:55 to play. We'll step aside and be back in just a moment after this on the CSU Sports Network.
Imagine a place where learning pushes you further and strengthens you from mind to toe. The promise of tomorrow begins with your commitment today. connect with people who open minds and open doors, taking you from here to there. We take pride in our legacy that prepares you for the rest of your life. Coppin State University.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, we all just got new smartphones at Cricket.
Hi.
Hi.
Hola.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Bye.
There is something greater than finishing first.
True champions stand on principles.
We fight for the right causes. We believe in the
power of teamwork, whether in rebounding, receiving, or in research.
In service and in sportsmanship.
Only a few have what it really takes.
We develop the talent. We unleash the potential.
It all boils down to this. Now
is the time. This is the place.
We are MEAC.
Ready to roll here in half number two at the under 16 media timeout. Mount St. Mary's leads it 43-42 over Coppin State here inside PEC Arena. If you're just joining us, I'm Kyle Borg here with you for the play-by-play here on the radio and on our live stream here on the CSU Sports Network. Coppin State's got the basketball out of the Juan Dixon timeout, which takes us to that media timeout. So 43-42 on the restart, 15:55 to play. Coppin in the home whites, Mount St. Mary's in the road blues. Coppin moves left to right while the Mount goes right to left. It's Coppin State basketball with Sam Sessoms. He'll be guarded full court by Jalen Benjamin. He'll fight it off. Benjamin keeps reaching in. Now he'll fire it to Tark. He's going to drive in. And he'll lay it in, and thank you. That's going to be the flop warning. There is absolutely no contact. Oh, no, it's not going to be a warning. It's going to be an immediate technical foul. So we will have technical free throws here in just a moment when we come back on the CSU Sports Network. All right. That was the official under 16 media timeout. So we're back. Coppin is going to get free throws after the Nendatark layup. So because of what – so Tark went in, got the layup. They called a flop on Reeves. There was absolutely no contact, 100% the right call. Now, last year, that was first going to be a warning, and then the technical foul assessed for one shot for the teams benefiting from that. Sessoms misses the technical free throw. He couldn't get it to fall as he was perfect on the year. And now Coppin will pick up full court. But now, because they're trying to clean up the flopping, it is an automatic technical foul with one shot for Coppin State. So they don't get the free throw. They do have a 44-43 lead with 14:41 to play. It's Mount St. Mary's basketball as Coppin State will pick up full court now in some full court pressure. Benjamin. Going to be trapped. Blue's coming over. He's trying to beat Sessoms on the sideline, and he does. Gets it to Gibson, and he'll fire it back out. They took up half the shot clock that time with the full court pressure. Blue guarding Benjamin. Now for Reeves. Underneath and one as Tinsley gets the layup to go. Tark picks up his second personal foul. And he was just trying to get in there as he was late to recover. This will give the Mount a two-point lead. Tinsley, 1-for-2 on the year, 50% free throw shooter coming in tonight. This is trip number one, and he got it, just barely. 46-44, Mount's got the lead. Steers with the basketball. Can't find Sessoms, almost lost his dribble. Now he does get it to him. Found the slip, Jefferson covered it nicely. Sessoms backing down Benjamin. Fires it out to Tark on the far wing. Spinning, lost the handle. Blue's got it. He wants three. Blue too strong. Rebound Rojas. Tark putting it on the floor. Gonna jump stop and pull up. No. In and out. Mount St. Mary's basketball. Benjamin. Far side of the floor, driving right into the hands of Steers. They got a 3-on-2. Now stopped, and Sessoms will pull up three in transition. Rattles it home, Sam Sessoms for three. 47-46, Coppin up by one. Back and forth we go between these two mid-majors. Both teams throwing punches like they did in the first half to start the second. Tinsley thought about it, over for Reeves, bobbled it but caught it anyway. Steps back, back for Tinsley. He wants a wide open jump shot, short, steers the board. Almost fell and traveled, but he kept his footing, and he'll find Sessoms. He'll cross the timeline. He's gonna back down Benjamin again. Jefferson comes over, steers, rising up, left hand! Count it and the foul! Justin Steers, too strong. Reeves picks up foul number one, the third on the team. And this can push the Coppin lead to four. If Steers can connect here. 76% on the year. One for two tonight as he sinks the free throw, and the Coppin lead up to four now, 50-46. Here's Lipscomb. He's guarded by Sessoms. Poked away by Steers. Diving on the floor for the loose ball is LeFou, who got it back from Jefferson. Catch and shoot three, in and out. Rebound, Justin Steers. Steers is ninth rebound. He's a point and a rebound away from his second consecutive double-double. Euro step right hand lay-in. Sam Sessoms again. Sessoms now up to 14. 52-46 underneath Rojas the foul. In and out. Lipscomb couldn't get it to go. He'll go to the line for the second time tonight for free throw attempts 2 and 3. He's 0-for-1 today and 0-for-1 on the year. 46-52, a 6-point Eagle advantage with 12:18 to go, second half. First free throw. The lefty got it. Cuts the lead to five. Here comes free throw number two. It's one for two at the line tonight. One for two on the year. The lefty again. Bouncing off the front of the rim and in. And here comes Bartone for Jefferson. 52-48, 12:18 to go. Coppin a four-point advantage. Tark will bring it up and give it up for Steers, who will start the offense. Coach Dixon wants Tark to take it control, and he does. Now finds Sessoms. He'll direct traffic. Spinning, getting to the right hand. Contact, no call. Rebound. Sessoms got it back. He'll go in this time. Whistle, foul and one. Another hoop and a harm for Coppin State. Sessoms with 14 to take us to the under 12 media timeout. We'll step aside and be back for a Sam Sessoms free throw. 11:55 remains in the contest. 54-48 Coppin on top.
Since 1837, historically black colleges and universities have been fulfilling their purpose to educate and empower. Since 2009, the Home Depot's Retool Your School Campus Improvement Grant Program has also been powered by a purpose to update, upgrade, and uplift HBCU campuses. Today, 44 million votes, $4.1 million, and 147 grants later, we remain inspired by the people, the passion, and the power of HBCUs to continue our purpose. Learn more at retoolyourschool.com.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
As technology is always innovating, we're always innovating the way we care. At MedStar Health, we have groundbreaking surgery that can save your life and groundbreaking therapy that gets you back to your life. MedStar Health, it's how we treat people.
Back inside the PEC arena with 11:55 remaining in the game. Coppin's up 54-48. Sam Sessoms picked up the and one. He'll get the free throw coming out of the break. He's 0 for 1 tonight, 2 of 3 on the year. And he will look to push the lead to 7 for Coppin State. So Sessoms, who shot the technical free throw a few minutes ago, missed that one. So he's 0 for 1 tonight, but again, 2 of 3 on the season. Now he's up to 16 points on 7 of 16 shooting. He'll look to make it 17 right here. Oof. Rattling in and off the backboard and in. More full court pressure from Coppin State. Rojas lets him go by, and Benjamin breaks the pressure rather easily. Tark lets him go by, and now the kick out for Bartone. Hand off LeFou. Back for Bartone. Corner shot, Lipscomb pump fakes, puts it on the floor underneath. Tinsley got three eagles in the air and got it to go on the left side with the right hand as he banks it home. 55-50, it's a five-point eagle lead. Coppin State basketball moving left to right. Isaiah Gross getting set to check in for the Eagles. Steers. Behind the back dribble, now gives it off for Tark on the handoff. He'll drive left, get to the left hand. Oh, he couldn't get the layup to go. Lipscomb driving hard to the basket. Left hand, no. Steers, had it tipped out of bounds. And it's going to stay with Mount St. Mary's with 11 to go. Gross in for Blue, and Sakalvich in for Steers, who isn't too pleased with having to check out of the game for Coppin State. 11 minutes to go in the second half. It's a five-point Eagle lead. 24 on the shot clock for Mount St. Mary's as they'll inbound left of their basket on the baseline. Couldn't get the lob into Jefferson. Instead, they lob it in for Benjamin, who will drive, kick it out Bartone. Left elbow jumper is good. Three-point game, 55-52. Tark for Sessoms. Going to get a screen, not going to use it. Now he'll step back, reject the screen again. Had it poked loose to Kalvich, trying to get on the floor. Now he does. Whistle, jump ball, arrow favors Coppin State. So now Hood comes in for Sessoms to get him a quick breather. 10:38 to play. 55-52, Coppin's on top, 10:38. Coppin will inbound near side of their basket. On the baseline, in for Tark on the right wing. He'll drive right baseline, now get back to the middle. Left hand, flip it up, took contact, and a really late whistle. Foul on Malik Jefferson, his third. In and out on the free throw from Nenda Tark. Number two, Gonzaga on the ropes on that aircraft carrier, the USS Abraham Lincoln over in San Diego. Michigan State's up 53-50. I don't know what the Carolina score is, but they were down 7 at the half at home, and they're the number one team in the nation. Could number one and number two go down tonight as Tark hits the second, 56-52. North Carolina and Charleston are tied at 68. That's going to be a battle. We'll keep our eye on that. Here's a three for the tie. No. Whistle and a foul. It's going to stay here. It's on to Kalvich. It's his third. Gross comes out for Justin Winston. 56-52, Eagles have the lead. It is Mount St. Mary's basketball on the baseline. Now they'll find Benjamin in the corner and they'll get it in. He wants three over Tark, too strong, rebound tipped away. On the floor, timeout Mount St. Mary's. Extracurriculars from Tkalvich, and we're gonna have, oh, and they've just ejected Tkalvich from the game. But are we gonna eject anybody else? Because there was shoves thrown. We're going to come back and we're going to look at it. This is going to be fun. Here we go. We'll sort it all out. We'll take a break. Timeout Mount St. Mary's after this. All right, we have our explanation from our officiating crew. Here we go. What we have, it will be Mount St. Mary's basketball. Let's start there. Luka Tkaljovic, number 33 for Coppin State, has picked up a flagrant one technical foul and has been ejected from the ball game. Dakota LeFou, wearing number one in blue for Mount St. Mary's, has picked up a dead ball technical foul, and the two technicals are going to offset each other, but Tkaljovic will be ejected from the game, and Mount St. Mary's is going to keep the basketball. That is the explanation we got from our crew chief, Jose Carrion, and Howard Davis and Larry Johnson Jr., our three officials tonight. I think I communicated that correctly from what I was told here at the table. So no free throws. We have no free throws. Mount St. Mary's retains possession. So what caused the dead ball was the Mount St. Mary's timeout before a jump ball could be held. So both coaches left two timeouts remaining. Coppin will be without Tkaljovic for the rest of this game. So Mount St. Mary's basketball underneath for LeFou. And now it's communicated to the crowd from our public address announcer. So here we go. 10-13 to go, a four-point Coppin State lead. They'll be shorthanded by one the rest of the night. Inbounded. Illegal screen going to be called on Bartone. We're going to be rejoined here by Turk Mott on the broadcast. He's going to serve as our analyst for the next 10:06 and counting.
Thanks for having me back. It's a pleasure.
Well, it's always a nice talking to somebody else rather than to myself for 2 hours, so I do appreciate it. Kick out corner three, not going to take it. Winston back for Sessoms, who's back in the contest for the Eagles. Four-point lead, 9:50 to go. The Sessoms underneath. Winston, three. Hood wants it. No, in and out. And a rebound for Jalen Benjamin. His 16 points lead the game for Mount St. Mary's. Right behind Sessoms, a 17, leads the game. LeFou, contact, no whistle. Ball tipped around. Mount St. Mary's is going to keep possession. So as we talked about at the half, when we were talking at the break, it was turnovers and defense. We're going to be the keys for Coppin State. Aside from converting on the offensive end, how would you say the turnovers and the defense has been as I say that Benjamin hits a jump shot?
Well, Benjamin has been key for these guys tonight, and we're just having a hard time locating him. The turnovers stopped our momentum. We had a five-point lead, and we had a couple costly turnovers, and Mount St. Mary's got the momentum, and they're back in this game.
The lead is down to two, and a foul on Jalen Benjamin. It'll be his second. It'll be his second. So, team's eighth. It's going to be one-and-one free throws coming for Nenda. Lots of fouls in this second half, but I would say that they haven't been unnecessary whistles.
No, the fouls have been this game is getting a little chippy because both teams want to win. Both teams feel they should walk out of here with a victory. When you get two teams that feel that way, you're going to have some chippiness.
And you know what? When you're only, what, an hour or so away from each other,
that helps.
Now St. Mary's coming from Emmitsburg here to Baltimore today. It's a quick road trip. Don't have to stay anywhere. We're going to sleep in our own beds tonight.
Yep.
As Tark misses the front end of the 1-1, and now free throws becoming key. The Mount starting to hit theirs. Coppin missing theirs as of late. 9 minutes to go. A two-point Eagle lead. Benjamin with the basketball. Over for Jefferson at the high post on the left elbow. He's going to drive. Now kick. Bartone not even going to think about shooting. And back out top to center court for Benjamin. Driving in, corner shot. Did Tark get a piece? He might have. Rebound Jefferson. Nobody boxed him out. And we're tied at 56. That has been Coppin State's Achilles heel over the last couple years, is the rebounding on the defensive side. Approaching the under eight media timeout as Sessoms drives in, flips it up. Oh, he couldn't get it to go.
Coppin State can't rebound. They're going to have a difficult time winning ball games.
Hood gets blown by, and that's going to be goaltending. Count the basket. That's a good eye from the officials. One of the tougher calls in basketball to make live is that goaltend. And I think if that ball was on the glass, as Blue and Rojas are going to check in for Winston and Hood. Or for... who's coming out? Steers is coming out. Steers and Hood are going to come out. .820 to go. 58-56, the Mount now with the lead and the basketball. Sessoms up top. Tark, he wants a three from 27 feet. Too strong off left. Here comes Benjamin. Next whistle takes us to the under eight media timeout. It's been pretty much the Jalen Benjamin show here tonight.
Jalen Benjamin is a difficult guy to stop. He reminds me of a poor man's Allen Iverson. Small but very, very efficient. Very well worth putting buckets on the score.
And after the missed shot, they almost got the stop. But again, Malik Jefferson on the offensive glass gets the layup to go. 4-point Mount lead. They go back and forth. Basketball, a game of runs. Mount's on one right now. Sessoms off the screen from Winston. Steps back. Gets the re-screen. Stepping back. He wants three. You bet! Bang! Timeout, Juan Dixon. 59-60. The Mount's got the lead. That should take us to the media timeout. It's going to take us to the media timeout. We'll step aside and be back in just a moment after this on the CSU Sports Network.
People who come to cricket stay with cricket.
With my cricket plan, everything is consistent. It's always going to be the same price. No worries.
Cricket is easy, it's affordable, customer service is top-notch. That's why I've been with them for so long.
I got my phone from Cricket and it's amazing. As a journalist, I use it for basically everything.
Great phones, great deals. Now that's a story. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Beautiful day in Baltimore, where most people probably know that Geico could save their money on car insurance, right? Well, could help them save on boat insurance too.
Okay. Request to come ashore.
Geico.
Welcome back inside the PEC Arena. Kyle Borg and Turk Mott here with you for the remainder of this contest at the under eight media timeout. It is 60-59. Mount St. Mary's has a 1-point advantage, and it was a Sam Sessoms three just a moment ago to get Coppin back within one.
I've watched this kid since he was in 10th grade, and Mount St. Mary's do not want to see him get started. This guy can fill it up.
And you know what? He's up to 20 for the second time in three games, a 20-plus point night. And there's a reason that Sam Sessoms scored over 1,000 points in a year and a half at Binghamton.
That guy is really crafty. You know, he's a smaller guy, he's quick, and he can find his way around a basket. He has a pretty good shooting form, so he can fill it up from three.
And he's got those pro-type moves, and we've seen it here a couple times tonight, a couple fadeaway jump shots, the spin. It's just, he looks like a pro's pro, and there's a reason that he's played in the Big Ten for years, for a couple years at Penn State.
I don't know how well he'll do in the NBA, but this guy's going to make a lot of money playing overseas.
Absolutely. It is Mount St. Mary's basketball up by one, looking to add on to that lead. They got 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Ahead for LeFou. Bartone pump fakes, driving in, stops, three, right-handed hook off left. Rebound Rojas. Here he comes. It's Sessom. Behind the back dribble. Behind the back pass. Winston. Layup is good.
Sam Sessom, ladies and gentlemen.
And the roof comes off the PEC arena after the fancy dribbling and pass from Sam Sessom.
That kid is really crafty in traffic.
Three. Tinsley, no. Offensive rebound. Batted for and a foul. Is that going to be on Sessom? It is on Sessom. It's just his first. So 1-1. As Jefferson checks back in. So Sessom, who's coming off a double-double at Georgetown with 16 points, 10 assists, and 4 steals, has 20 points tonight, 4 rebounds, and 3 assists as well, and a steal in 31 minutes and counting for the redshirt senior. Offensive rebound off the 1-1 front end miss. Benjamin gets it. He'll sidestep. Now he's caught on the baseline, able to dribble back out and circle. Long three on the way. Air ball. Jefferson trying to save it. He does. He finds Reeves. Reeves gets the layup and the Mounts back on top.
That is just a great rebound, save, and assist all in one possession.
Wow, 62-61. Here is Sessom. Blocking foul on number 5, Jalen Benjamin. That's 3. And he's playing all up in the grill of Sam Sessom, so he's got to be careful with those because it's going to be 9 times out of 10 a block unless Sessom throws the arm out there.
Yes, definitely. If he can win, if Sam can win that matchup, Coppin State has a better chance of winning it. We can get 2 more fouls on Benjamin. Coppin State has a really good chance of winning.
And you know what? Both sides with 3 players in double digits. Sessom's 20, Blue 10, Tark 12 for Coppin, LeFou 17, Tinsley 11, Benjamin 18. So balanced scoring all the way around. A little bit more for Coppin as here's the front end of the 1-1. Sessom ties the game at 62.
This is going to be a barn burner.
And like I said earlier, if this is a one possession game, to win, to tie, or what? If Coppin gets, you better make sure Coppin doesn't have the last shot. 4 of 5 on game winners last year, all Nenda Tark. The one they missed, Tark didn't take. So he was 4 for 4, and then Mike Hood is 1 for 1 to tie games this year against Georgetown to force overtime. So I'm just going to throw it out there now with 5:45 remaining. If you're Mount St. Mary's, you better make sure you have the last shot.
Who do you want taking that shot if you're Mount St. Mary's?
Benjamin. It's got to be Benjamin. High arcing layup try, high off the glass. No, he tried to do his best Steph Curry impression. 4 on 3. Tark all the way in on Jefferson. Takes contact, but he couldn't get it to fall. 63-62. More free throws coming for Coppin State. They're 7 of 12 here tonight. They were very good at the line against Georgetown, and it really kept them in it. But just 58% here tonight. On the year, 78% through 2 games for Coppin State as a team. Tark, 17 points, 6 boards, and 4 steals at Georgetown. He's got, make it 13 points, 2 boards, 3 assists, 3 steals, and a pair of blocks. But it is now plus 11 Mount St. Mary's rebounding, and Coppin has been able to go plus 1 in turnovers now as he missed the second free throw. 63-62. Blocked, but a foul on Sam Sessom. Ah, it's going to be Sam's second. Or he hit the second, excuse me. 64-62 is the score.
Mount St. Mary's ran that play like a well-oiled machine.
And they got Bartone to the line. He sinks the first. He is now 1 for 1.
This kid has been pretty solid for them. He knocks the mid-range down. He rebounds. He had a couple tip-outs for rebounds. He's been playing well for them.
Missed that one. He's now 2 for 8 on the year. Tark. Underneath, backing down, left-handed hook, got it to go. Nenda Tark. 5 minutes to go, a 3-point Coppin advantage. Tried to split the double, couldn't do it. Gross on the floor, corrals it, gets it to Tark. He's got Winston, dribble. Lays it off, Tark up, left hand, no, to Sessoms. Or excuse, Gross. Sessoms with it at the top of the key, fresh 20 on the clock. He'll drive right, find Tears. He'll go up, under and muscle it down with a two-handed jam. A 5-point Eagle lead. Time out. Mount St. Mary's with 4:28 to go.
I'm really proud of this Coppin State team. They just showed excellent patience. Patience that would have took them to the winning virtue of the last game versus Georgetown.
A 7-1 run over the last minute 47 of gameplay for the Eagles to take a 68-63 lead here late in the second half. 4:28 remaining. As you take a look on the live stream at the replay, that's Sessoms dumping it off on the bounce pass to Steers in the dunker spot. He pump fakes. He got both in the air. Oh, he got away with a travel.
He got away
with a big-time travel. He changed his pivot foot twice. But nonetheless, a two-handed dunk from Justin Steers, and he loves that spot, in that dunker spot where you just catch one step and go up with it. That is his favorite spot on the floor, and for good reason.
He was highly effective using that same move against Georgetown.
And with 21 points and, what was it, 12 rebounds?
I think he had 13. 12 or 13?
21 points. He was 5 of 10 from the floor, shot 50%, 11 of 13. He lived at the free throw line against Georgetown.
That kid is very impressive. His athletic ability is very impressive.
He's got 11 points tonight, 9 rebounds, and 5 of 6 from the floor here this evening. And you know what? Leaps and bounds for Justin Steers over the offseason. Early on last year, Justin Steers was just kind of there, coming off the bench, doing the little things well. Late in conference play and in the conference tournament, he came on. And when he had a couple 20-point games down the stretch, I think he even had one at Howard in that big win on the road late in February last year. But Justin Steers this year has just continued where he left off in March.
That is really good for a kid like him. This is my second time seeing Justin play, and I'm equally impressed.
And you know what? If he can continue this level going forward this year, it's a three-headed monster that you got to try and stop for opposing teams. It's Tark, Sessoms, and then Steers.
I would say we have maybe a 4 or 5-headed monster. You got a lot of different guys that can lead this team in scoring depending on the game.
Well, and you got to worry about Cameron Blue.
Yes.
Who's got 10 points. He had a hot start. He's still shooting 4 of 6, has been on the bench most of the second half, foul trouble, some little mistakes as well. That's why he's sitting over there. And once Mike Hood gets going again, Mike Hood will be great off the bench as well. And then Justin Winston. But it's the three of them, and then those role players that we just talked about are going to be huge. And if they can continue to produce and be effective, Coppin State will be a dangerous team.
I could not agree more.
Tinsley corrals it. He'll take a turnaround jump shot. Got it to go. 65-68 Coppin lead. 4:10 to play. We will likely on the next whistle have our under 4 media timeout. They're trying to find Sessoms. He's going to be guarded tightly all year long. Now they find him with 15 to shoot. Next whistle to the media. Winston going to pop out. Not going to screen. Winston. Left wing. He's going to keep it. You know he's going to shoot it with 5. Now 4. Step back. Takes a 3 off 1 foot. No. Steers tipped the rebound. Tinsley caught. And he'll fire it to Jefferson. And now they have a chance to tie. 3-point game. Reeves for the tie. Short. Justin Steers, the big 10th rebound for his second consecutive double-double. Here's Sessoms driving in. Blocking foul. Easy call. Count the bucket and 1 for Sam Sessoms.
And that's going to be Benjamin's 4th, I think.
It's his 3rd. Team's 10th. 1 free throw for Sessoms. With 3:27 to go, he can push the lead to 6. He does. Gonzaga just survived the upset bid from Michigan State at the buzzer. 64-63 over in San Diego. Gonzaga survives. What a game here on Veterans Day. We got a game here, 71-65. Mount St. Mary's driving in, kick, corner, Reeves three on the second try, connecting, and it's a three-point game.
That corner three has been a thorn in the side of the Coppin State's defense.
Tark with it, off the double screen. Driving, turned it over, chance to tie. Oh, might have got away with the travel. Now ahead for Benjamin, underneath again, Reeves. Pump fake, puts it on the deck, steps back, and we are tied at 71. Wow. Two big-time low-major teams throwing haymakers here to start the season. Sessoms driving in. Euro steps blocked from behind. It's going to stay with Coppin State. 2:23 to go, 16 to shoot for the Eagles.
We're going to need Sam to keep his composure here if we're going to come out with a win.
Once again, Sessoms with 25. Second time this year. Inside, Winston gets it to go.
Tough move by Winston. Could have been a foul, ref score otherwise.
Underneath, turnover, Winston comes up with it, but he couldn't corral it. Benjamin on Gross, kicks it out. Three, too strong. Rebound, Tinsley underneath. Oh, he traveled. Great call coming from the official.
I tell you what, Coppin State got lucky there because it looks like that was going to be another corner three from the mount.
Reeves has just been living there over the last 45 seconds. 73-71 with a 1:54 to play. Strap in, folks. It's going to be a tight one down the stretch. Sessoms got separation. He'll bring it up, guarded by Benjamin. Both teams with one timeout remaining for the next minute, 45. Sessoms drives in. Oh, he got it blocked from behind. Who was that? I think that was LeFou. Here comes Benjamin. Lost the handle. Blocked by Tark. Up ahead, Sessoms, Winston, right-handed layup is good. 75-71, Coppin a four-point lead. Here comes Benjamin for Mount St. Mary's in the middle of the floor. He'll drive left, find Jefferson, left-handed floater, got it to bounce home off the front of the rim, 75-73. You don't have to play the foul game just yet, but Steers avoids a steal. Winston driving in, reverse layup. Yep, it's a four-point game. Winston's got 11. Coach Dixon barking out defensive instructions. LeFou back for Benjamin. Now for Tinsley. It's the double inside. Whistle, block. Oh, a late blocking call on Isaiah Gross. He might have been in the circle.
I think this game might be speeding, going a little bit too fast for the officials.
Referees telling them no timeout. Let's go.
It was a late call, but it was the correct call.
80. That's close.
Did he have a foot in?
He was outside the circle.
Oh, wow.
He might have moved just late.
I think he was still moving.
And, of course, that call in live time, bang, bang, you just got to pick. But it was a late whistle, so the hesitation probably should have just gone no call. But that's all right. It'll be two free throws. It's Gross's second personal, and he got the first to go. .43 to go, three-point game. Again, both sides with a timeout remaining. Benjamin's at the line where he's a 70% free throw shooter, 3 of 4 tonight, making 4 of 5, and it's a two-point game again. You could play this out if you're Mount St. Mary's. Sessoms in trouble. Has to get it away. He does. Winston cutting again. Two-handed slam. Up high and down hard. Justin Winston, 79-75.
The Mount could go for a two-for-one here.
And they will. They got Gross on the block. He didn't move his feet at all. That's the right call. He just kind of stood there and stuck his chest out. That's going to be a block every time. Shot clock's going to be turned off here, or at least it should as we go to the line. It does. 28 seconds to go at 79-75. Can Coppin hang on?
I'm Mount St. Mary's here. I make two free throws, and I'm pressing the ball. Hope Coppin State is getting in there, press offense.
He missed it. So now do you try to intentionally miss and get a rebound, which you've been successful doing, and try and get that two back, or are you just going to hit the free throw?
Now you make the free throw. You go for a trap. Once they cross half court, you take a foul.
Mount St. Mary's does have the possession arrow. He does get that to go. And now defensive substitutions now for Mount St. Mary. So the Mount retains that possession arrow due to that scrum earlier in this half that got Tekovic ejected and the technical on LeFou. So that could be big here on this trap. 28 seconds, you don't have to foul immediately. It's a three-point game. They get it to Steers, and they do foul immediately. But I'm not sure Justin is the one you wanted to foul.
If you're who?
Mount St. Mary's. If you're Mount St. Mary's, I don't think he's the one. He's decently consistent for Coppin, and he has been his whole career. All right, he's 1-for-2 tonight.
What's his percentages?
Coming into today, 76.5.
That's about 8 out of 10.
So he's now 14 of 18 on the year after this 1-for-2 earlier today. 26.9 on the clock. He missed the front end of the two. All right, I know people say 4 points is two possessions, but it's not. Stranger things have happened. It's
yes, just it
is. It's one shot. It's an and 1-3, which the odds of that happening are slim. But it's still a one-possession game. It's likely two, but with the make, which he does, it's a four-point game.
It's a possibility, but
they're not going to try
it. Not a probability.
Benjamin there for Tinsley. He lost the handle. Benjamin gets it back. He's going to drive in. Two, no. Winston the board. He gets it to Sessoms. And Sessoms is fouled, and it looks like Coppin is going to hang on. Once again, in the second half, 46 points for Coppin in this half and counting. Sessoms. In and out. Oh, it's still four. They continue to keep it interesting. But that's unfortunate for Tinsley down here. He bobbled the wide open look going up. I think he saw that defender coming on late, and he just hesitated. Five-point game, two possessions, 81-76. Got to go. Benjamin going to take the two. Reverse layup's good. Timeout with 8.7 to go.
Still a three-point game with 8 seconds. That's a lot of time.
If you can find a way to get two misses at the free throw line, as the Mount will use their final timeout. If you can find a way, and then the question becomes, you miss both free throws. You're up three. Are you putting them at the line for two free throws to play the foul game and get it back?
Absolutely, without question. You do not let
you are the foul up three.
You do not let a team like Mount St. Mary's get a three-point shot off when you're down three.
8 of 27 from deep for the Mount tonight. That's 29.6% if you're doing the math at home. I am more, let's play it out. You guys just got to play good defense, and if they hit a shot, they hit a shot. That's where I stand on that, but of course every coach is going to be different, so I'm sure that's what Juan's going over here in the huddle. If we miss both, which we're not, we're going to hit both, but if we do, you're going to foul what? With about 5 seconds? Or as soon as they cross half court?
Yeah, when they cross half court.
In this situation, because you don't want to foul a guy going into the motion, because
Correct.
You don't want the referees to have to make a call, because Correct. If they do, they're going to come over and they're going to look at it.
Yep, yep, yep.
And you don't want to do that. So you got to say, as soon as they get to half court, you're fouling. We'll see if that ends up playing out, but Coppin's got to get the ball in. That's the first step here.
The most important.
You got to get. They do have a timeout, which is good. And he can move the baseline, which is good. 81-78, 8.7 seconds to go. Coppin basketball, Coppin three-point lead. Did you take a look at Coach Dixon right there on your screen? They're going to try and get it to Sessoms, and they do. And he tiptoes the sideline and is fouled. And what was that, about 1.5 seconds come off the clock? 7.2 remain.
I played about 15 years overseas. And when I first got there, the game was tied, and my coach had us fouled. We fouled when the game was tied. We fouled when we were up one, up two. It was a free throw shooting game.
Interesting.
Every night.
Play those percentages. We'll see what Sessoms does. 5 of 7 tonight. He got the first to make it a four-point game. Breathing room for Coppin State. Now if he misses this, you definitely do not want to get in that landing space of that three-point shooter.
I think Coppin still has to play solid defense because they might go for a two one more time. They might go for a two and foul one more time.
Well, let's see what Benjamin does. Three, he's running out of time. Quickly up ahead, the three. In and out, Tark rebound. Eagles win. 83-78. Coppin State is victorious at home. In their home opener over the in-state rival Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers. Well, they got it done.
Got it done. They were shy of my 7 points, but they got it done. A win is a win.
A win is a win. Sam Sessoms, a new season high, 28 points on 9 of 22 shooting, 5 rebounds, 5 assists in 38 minutes of action to lead all scorers here tonight. On the flip side, Jalen Benjamin, 23 big points for Mount St. Mary's on that side of the floor. As they're going to play the alma mater. So we are going to step aside and take a break, and we will be back after this on the CSU Sports Network for our post-game wrap-up.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to join us on Monday, November 14th, when the Eagles host the midshipmen of the United States Naval Academy. Tip off at 7 p.m. We look forward to seeing
back
you here as
Pack
the PC
for
the Eagles and the midshipmen.
Until
then, drive,
the
ride, or walk safely. We'll see you Monday night here at the PC. Until
off,
then, have a very pleasant and
right.
Good night, everyone.
So we will get Coach in just a moment here. As soon as he's ready to go, here we go. All right, Coach Juan Dixon here on the broadcast. Coach, first and foremost, congratulations on the victory. It was a hard-fought one.
It was.
83-78 final, and you guys were led by Sam Sessoms, 28 points.
Yeah, we'll take it, man. You know, we talked to the guys before the game about whatever it takes, however it looks. You know, we just need to get in that W column. And we did tonight. You know, our fans were great. Sam picked it up in the second half. But we got to keep fighting. We got to do better defensively as a team. And I'm going to put that on the coaches, starting with myself and six members of my staff. We got to do better when it comes to helping these young men execute better on the defensive end, because scoring is not going to be an issue. This young man can put the ball in the basket. You got Ninja Tark. We have shooters. We have skilled bigs. We just got to keep competing and playing hard for the entire 40 minutes.
And, Coach, you had five players in double-digit scoring. Like, yeah, you said, not a problem. But that defensive side, you were out-rebounded tonight, but I felt like you guys were able to control the glass when it mattered.
Yeah, we got some timely defensive rebounds, some timely offensive rebounds. But I'm going to harp on the defensive end. That's something as a staff we've been hanging our hat on since we've been here at Coppin State. And we're going to continue to do so. I'm confident that we're going to get it straight, straightened out. And we just got to continue to help these young men be confident, remain confident, play confident. But most importantly, being dogs on the defensive end of the floor.
And, Coach, you guys will host Navy here on Monday night, yep, for your second straight home game. What are your keys going into that one?
Compete hard on the defensive end for 40 minutes and rebound. Like I said, offensively, you know, I give my guys freedom. We have a point guard that's a dynamic scorer. We have a wing in Ninja Tark that dynamic. He can do it at all three levels. So I'm going to let my guys play. As long as they play the right way offensively, which we're going to continue to get better, I'm going to let them play. I'm going to let them hoop.
Coach, congratulations on the
win.
We'll see you on Monday
night. Appreciate you, man. Thank you.
And now we will be joined by our player of the game, the Penn State transfer. It will be Sam Sessoms. Sam, welcome to the broadcast. Thanks for joining us. First time this year, probably first of many is what I suspect, but 28 points, your new season high, mm-hmm, in this young season. What was the key for you offensively tonight?
Honestly, I was having a hard time finding my rhythm in the first half. I had a lot of, stupid mistakes, travels, turnovers, but coach told me just, keep trusting my teammates, and I just waited to get my opportunities in transition to get my touches, got a couple free throws in, then I finally got my rhythm down the stretch.
And you know what? That late defensive effort, you guys were trading punches and five-point leads, it seemed like, and then all of a sudden, after that media timeout at the under four, your defense picked up, your rebounding picked up. What was the key for you guys late?
We wasn't trying to go 0-3. Honestly, we felt like we let one slip versus Georgetown. We felt like we was better than this team if we executed, so that last media timeout, we just told ourselves, like, imagine how that feeling would be if we lost, We had the key in on defensive rebounds and stops, and we knew we didn't want to trade punches, so we were able to lock in and play like the older team we are.
And you know what? You guys have one more at home before you hit the road again on Monday night. You'll play Navy here inside the PEC Arena. What are your team's keys? What do you think they are going in for victory for your second straight?
Honestly, man, our defense has been horrible, starting with me. Me being a starting point guard, fifth year, senior transfer, coming from a school like Penn State, me and Ninda has to set the tone on defense, but I've been having a lot of slip-ups lately on defense, and it's hard for me and Ninda to lead by example and say something to our teammates if we're not doing it. So, honestly, I think we need to lock back into our defense because that's what Coppin State basketball is, and it starts with me. I have to be better, and I will be better for the team.
Well, Sam, first off, congratulations on the win, and we will see you on Monday night.
Thank you, man. Have a good night.
That was the redshirt senior Sam Sessoms joining us on the broadcast, wrapping up with our player of the game. Mount St. Mary's will fall to 0-2 on the season, and their next home game will be next Tuesday against McDaniel College. They will play their first home game on Tuesday. While Coppin State goes to 1-2 on the year, they pick up an early win here in the first week of the regular season. They will play at home Monday night against the midshipmen of the U.S. Naval Academy before hitting the road for a long stretch to end November and start the month of December. Well, that's going to do it for us here on the CSU Sports Network. For everybody here, I'm Kyle Borg saying have a great rest of your night, and we will see and talk to you on Monday. So with five, now four, step back, takes a three off one foot, no, steers, tipped the rebound, Tinsley caught.
Bethel, and a guard, six. Bethel. Bethel.
With five, now four, step back, takes a three off one foot, no, steers. With five, now four, step back, takes a three.
Last year in the championship game. It's last year in the championship game.